What's good, y'all? It's Jay Coffee on the vid. Welcome back to another episode of Jay Coffee Talk. Got a variety of topics to get into, you know what I'm saying? Some music news, some very sad news that we gotta go over with y'all, and some other ish, some court stuff, a variety, like I said. So let's get it, man. You heard that first clip there, Nicki Minaj at the Met Gala. And she's confronting some kind of paparazzi or media guy. You heard her like, "You're the one that leaked that I was gonna be here. I'm gonna come slap the ish out of you over there." And I don't know, like, what do y'all think? Was she clowning around or was she serious? I swear, I can't really tell with Nicki. I really can't, man. Yo, the Barbs is such a devoted fan base. Can we talk about that? Whether you're into Nicki's music or not, that fan base is wild. Like, you don't want to get into a Twitter dispute with the Barbs, okay? I personally never went there, but I've seen it happen. It gets ugly. There's just so many of them, you know? But what do you think, guys? Like, say Nicki was in a situation like this, or how she was just in this situation, but say Ish got, you know, it's got crazy or whatever. Do you think if there was a lot of Barbs in attendance, you know what I'm saying, would they assemble like Voltron and just, you know, help have Nicki's back? Or do you think like the Barbs ain't really like that? I don't know. I mean, it's a large group of fans, so I guess you can't really generalize people like that. But what do y'all think of the Barbs, and what do you think about this situation? You know, was she tripping, or was she just clowning around here? I guess she just wanted to surprise everyone by being at the Met Gala is what the deal was. And, you know, he took the suspense away, maybe. I don't know. Tap in, comment. All right, man. Then we got to get to some very, very sad news. Very just, you know, I've been aware of this situation before. But it's been a while since I heard an update on it. And it's just heartbreaking to see, man. You see, we're talking about Steve Mongo McMichael. Okay, y'all know Jay Coffee Talk is a wrestling fan, and I still got a lot of wrestling ish in the works. Actually, one should be dropping very soon. I know I've been saying that. I'm sorry, guys, forgive me. You know, I've really been just tied up, man, so busy lately. But Mongo, as you see this picture, like, it's just heartbreaking to see this man like this. You know, he was a warrior. What, played for the 85 Bears? You see the picture of him hoisting Ditka on his shoulders, was a part of that, you know, history making squad. He was in WCW during the era, the best era. Like, wrestling fans, can we agree that was just the truth back then? And just thinking back on that, you know, that era of wrestling, the Monday Night Wars, everything that was going on with WCW, like, it'll just never be like that again. I don't think that it will. And Mongo gets criticized at times. Oh, he couldn't really work. He shouldn't have been in the Horsemen. I don't know. I liked Mongo. I mean, yes, he wasn't the greatest wrestler, okay? Like, he wasn't some guy that was just going to blow you away with his in-ring work. But I felt like he put on some pretty decent matches. But I liked the fact that he was a legitimate living NFL legend, and that he didn't just, you know, come, like, we've seen guys like Lawrence Taylor, a one-off, you know, WrestleMania wrestle Bam Bam Bigelow and beat him, right? We saw Kevin Green in WCW a few times. Like, we've seen people cross over from the sports world into wrestling. Pac-Man Jones in TNA, even though he couldn't even take one single bump. Ron Killings had to do all the work for that tag team. But Mongo, like, got trained to wrestle and wrestled for real, was really living that lifestyle. And I like this swagger and energy. And, you know, everything you hear about Steve Mongo McMichael, like, that's really who he was. So it just fit the pro wrestling world so good. And I thought he was a good addition to the Four Horsemen. You know, I hear at times some people say that incarnation of the stable was Buns. I don't know. I liked it. I don't know, man. Comment and let me know what you guys think about that Four Horsemen of that era. But like I said, this isn't new news. We know that he's been in this battle for his life, but it is just terrifying, sad, and so many other just ways I could put this to see Mongo in this situation. You know, ALS, he was diagnosed back in 2019. And like I said, this guy was a warrior. I mean, he still is. That's what we want to talk about. Even, you know, being bed bound, you see people coming and taking pictures with him. And that's been cool, too. Like a lot of it's being reported, a lot of pro wrestlers, a lot of his, you know, former NFL teammates or rivals or whatever have come and seen him. Like, people want Mongo to know he's not been forgot about, but it's just crazy. Like, you see people taking pictures with him and they have to like hold him up. It just breaks my heart, man. It's really sucks to see this. But like I said, he's a warrior, was a warrior and still is, because that's what's being put out there from his wife and from those who are in close contact with him, that, you know, Mongo likes to have people around. He's not just sitting there in bed going, okay, my life's over, what am I gonna do? He's trying to stay positive and do what he's got to do, you know, to survive. That computer that they give you, that we used to see like Stephen Hawking with, you know, to talk and everything, I guess it's just freaks me out to hear about this too. Like, it reads your eye movements and everything and helps you communicate. Mongo ain't fucked with it one bit, you know. Like, I guess when and if it does, because let's pray for Mongo and hope it, you know, he recovers or things get better. Even though this is, like I said, this is just a terrifying disease. Like, it's crazy too, even with how much medical science and everything and research has, like, you know, hepatitis has been cured and, you know, people have walked again who they never thought would and everything. That they don't know that much about ALS. That's what's freaky about it. Like, that it just happens one day, you know. Can you imagine that? I hate even going there in my head, you know. But Mongo doesn't, like, he's like, nah, I'm gonna be like this. If it goes that route, I guess he's gonna have to you know, rock with the computer. But as it stands now, he's just trying to keep fighting day by day, stay positive, not give up on life, watching cowboy movies, westerns and everything, and, you know, trying to keep in contact with everyone. That's why, like, sometimes when you see money raised, Chris Jericho, I think, got something going that raised a good amount of money for Mongo. And you know, sometimes people say, oh, these are celebrities, they're athletes, they're rich, fuck all that, I ain't putting no money in, you know, to that cause. They already been rich. It's true. But what's so crazy about this disease is financially it'll bleed you dry. Insurance only covers so much, and Mongo has to have a 24 hour a day nurse right by his side. Ain't that crazy? So I don't know, guys, you know, tap in, comment, share your thoughts. Again, isn't it just wild to see him? He's 64 years old and just doesn't even look like the same person at all. Now, he was diagnosed back in 2019. And typically, like I said, there's not really a lot of, you know, info and research on this disease. But typically, like, 4 years is 4 years is a life expectancy, I guess. And, you know, it's 2022, but Mongo says he's still going strong. So comment with your thoughts, you know, about Mongo as an athlete, his career, your favorite moments by him. Did you like him in wrestling? Do you remember that era of wrestling? Do you know anyone with ALS? Let's talk about it all below in the comment threads. To anyone new that's over here, as always, guys, the comment section is what this platform is really all about. Coffee talking it up with you guys, so don't be shy, tap in, let's talk. Now, moving along, something I discussed a little bit on this channel is this situation going on with Johnny Depp again. I can't ever recall a civil suit being aired on TV like this, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's been so much hype and so much coverage with this case. Typically, like, that's a big, like, true crime case or something that gets this kind of coverage. But no, this is just Johnny Depp's civil suit, you know, with Amber Heard. And again, you know, I'm no relationship expert or anything like that, but I always got to point out, like I was just talking on my live earlier about someone really close to me going through some real terrible fucked up ish in their relationship. And I always put it out there that, you know, I see a lot of people jump into relationships that maybe they don't wholeheartedly want to be in, or stay in ones that are fucked up just because they feel like they got to be in a relationship. And just personally, I don't think people should ever do that. You know what I'm saying? Things become a toxic mess. And that's what, you know, really this whole situation between Johnny Depp and Amber Heard sounds like to me. You know what I mean? They just seem to hate each other, but stayed together. And then, you know, we're concerned of how things would come out to the press and all that regarding them, you know, because they're actors and their image means everything. And, you know, so comment with your thoughts about the case, who you think will win and all that. But an expert witness just came in. Some guy testified speaking about, you know, that Depp's name being fucked up will ruin his career in the future. You know, that actors that get essentially canceled can't really make money in the industry no more. You know, do you guys think that that's going to be the effect of Johnny Depp, that his name is going to be all bad and his career will die off? Or do you think he, you know, like, I don't know. I'm not saying let's pick sides in this, but what do you believe? You know, do you think Johnny Depp was fucked up, or do you think this just was a mess from both sides? I don't know. Do you think his career will be killed from this? And let's talk about Johnny Depp's career. Okay, obviously this guy's had an amazing career, been in all kinds of movies. Comment what your favorite roles Johnny Depp's played in. Comment what your favorite movies he's been in. I swear, I just earlier, you know, looking for a movie to watch, scrolled by Black Mass. You know, the Whitey Bulger movie. And yo, Johnny Depp looked fucking creepy and evil as Whitey Bulger, right? Am I lying or what? Come on. Like, tell me he didn't look bugged the fuck out. Like, you're like, damn, that's not you, Johnny, is it? And then to close it out, man, last little topic we got here. Tory Lanez still in the midst of all this ish going on with Meg Thee Stallion, which we've seen getting a lot of extra coverage again as of late. You know, this, think about it, y'all. This story has not really left the news cycle since it happened. I mean, there was times things kind of died down a little bit or whatnot. But, you know, she did that interview with Gayle King recently. So a lot of people within the hip hop world, you know, have been giving their take on it all. It seems a lot of people are standing in solidarity with Tory Lanez, saying they believe that he is indeed innocent. Well, he had some more police contact. And hopefully, like, it's not a serious situation, and I hope it stays that way. I hope, like, because if you guys recall, he had to end up, like, he technically was rearrested. Like, I don't know if he actually had the cuffs slapped on him and actually, like, went into custody, but technically when he went to court recently, he had to, you know, they revoked his bail, more or less. They put a higher bail on him and he had to bail out, you know, because they were saying some of the ish that was going on was like third party harassment and was violating the order of protection and all that. I don't know, it's been crazy. I still wonder how way back, even though it's not technically what he was violated over, but I feel like it kind of led up to it, the whole Rolling Loud situation that they both were like booked. I don't know, man. I wonder, like, that's crazy that was even able to happen. But I guess maybe both sides just kind of felt like, hey, if we just come here, get our money, do our business and get out of here and stay away from each other, it should be all good. I don't know. But that wasn't the case. And then the online ish, they said, yo, we're saying you violated the terms of that. We need to jack that bail up. Well, now he just got hemmed up in Vegas at the airport, and they're saying he had a bunch of weed in his bags. Now, like I said, it's not a serious situation because they detained him for a little bit and they said, okay, this amount of weed, the weight doesn't hit that of trafficking, so you're okay, you're gonna be good to go. They of course confiscated the weed, and you know, they took like an incident report and all that and passed it on to the Clark County District Attorney's office. I don't know, I don't think that they'll actually make a case behind this, but you know, it's crazy. Hopefully it doesn't affect that bail situation at all. I don't see why it should, but I wonder why Tory just had a bunch of weed in his bag like that. Like, come on, Tory, you're tripping, man. You got to move smarter than that, you know? But he was out in Vegas. I believe this was just like yesterday, just like Sunday, you know? It's been confirmed. You see, the reports have been confirmed, but Yeah, he came out, I guess, to do some kind of gig at Caesar's Palace. That probably was lit, man. Like, Tory's nice with the, like, Tory can flow, man. So comment with your thoughts on that one as well. That concludes this story. Let's talk about it. This episode. Let's talk about it all below in the comments. Again, I thank y'all for tuning in, new viewers. Or if you're just not subbed yet, do me that solid, guys. Please subscribe to the channel. Also hit that like button. You see, I'm on the grind trying to come up. You know, every interaction helps. So fuck with me, y'all. Look forward to talking to you in the comments. Stay tuned. New content coming. I'm gone.